mean, I studied other Kickstarter campaigns and I tried to learn how we do this. I mean, the first thing obviously you need is for someone, you need something that people are interested in actually supporting, right? That's important. But then I think you have to organize what we call premiums, essentially what people are donating money for in exchange for. And you just have to make those enticing. People have to want those. I mean, it's a combination of people wanting to support a particular project and people wanting to get something tangible as a result of their support. So a big part of it is figuring out what those premiums or rewards are going to be and making them as interesting as you can. Making them fun, making them, you know, funny, but also giving them value for their money. I mean, I've seen a number of Kickstarter campaigns where the premiums were just meager, and apparently they just thought they were just going to give them money because they like them. And a few people are going to do that, but really most people, you know, are essentially buying something. I mean, they're both supporting you and buying something, so you have this mixed motivation. And I think that's really the key. Well, I mean, I came up with like a core bunch of premiums that I gave my staff, and then they went and brainstormed and came up with all kinds of like really great, you know, great stuff, like hand-drawn chucks and going shooting with me, get a bunch of guns and go out to a national park and bring things like refrigerators and just shoot them. So they came up with a whole list of like really interesting, you know, stuff that I think would just jazz people. In addition to more conventional premiums like signed prints, by people like Robert Crumb or, you know, Jaime Hernandez, signed books, books with sketches in them, things like that. So I think you really need to brainstorm and have a good mix of interesting, enticing things. And then presentation is really important. I lucked out because my girlfriend's a filmmaker, you know, and then a good sort of honest, straightforward spiel as to what this thing is about. I think people like signed books, and you need a variety of awards. You need a variety of price points too. So you need everything from $1 or $5 up to whatever, you know, $1,000 or something. But you need a lot of items that are between $20 and $100. You know, because I mean, this is democratic in the sense that you're appealing to people who aren't rich. You're appealing to people like us who, you know, can spend $50 or $80 or $100, but, you know, beyond that, you got to think about it. So, you know, it looks to me like, you know, the majority of people are buying signed books, and they can range from something like $25 to $50. And then, you know, doing sketches and books, you know, more people are doing that. And then as you get, you know, higher priced, when you're selling fewer items. But I think you need that variety. And there are people in our Kickstarter program who bought the $2,000 package of every single book we're publishing next year. Kickstarter has this arcane process where, I hope I'm getting this right, but you can't order two items. You can only buy one thing, but you can order more than one if you actually talk to the people directly. And so we deal with a lot of people who write to us and say, I'd like to order, you know, these three items. And so we correspond with them. Now you can also talk to people on the Kickstarter website. They have a comment section and people post comments and you can reply directly to them. And that's been really good. And people can tell you what you're doing wrong and you thank them. Our first, well, you have what's called stretch goals. So if you meet your goal, then you post a stretch goal. What are you going to do with the additional money? So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create an infrastructure so that we can publish more European books. Because my partner, who died earlier this year, he was devoting a lot of his time and attention to editing and translating our European line of comics. And when he died, he was basically a one-man operation. He chose the books, he edited the books, and he translated the books. And no one else here speaks the languages. So we have to find translators, and we have to, you know, work with European publishers and so on. So our first stretch goal was that. And if we make it to a second stretch goal, it'll be to have a new website, which we, you know, We've had this rickety website for a few years now. It's time for a new one.